Ah, spring. The delightful spring. As I, that bloke just fired up that unit, the demo saw or whatever he's got. Have a glance over here, eh? There's a bloke there driving that thing. There's a cute bird that's working with him in construction. Awesome. She must be like early 20s or something like that. Some bloke's directing her to do whatever's in that road. It was quite a movement of that, some 15 years ago or something like that. There was a push to have people, let's see if I can just open up this energy drink here. There you go. There was, incidentally, a few years back, the bloke that, the owner of the RIP cat, he was walking up this way and I was walking down this way, and a few years back there was a koi fish over there, and he was sort of up on the embankment, and he got stuck high and dry, and these two crows in the neighborhood that I feed a lot, they were picking at him, and he was alive, and they were eating him alive. They opened up some blood on him, and I was like, "F this, we can't have that." And so I jumped down there and went all ninja style, and the crows weren't too pleased with me, but I feed them all the time, they can't hate me for that. And so I went over there, and they opened up a wound on the fish, and imagine a fish's elation when I just sort of nudged him into the water, and off he went down there to deeper water. Imagine his elation. Here he is, certain death. He's getting eaten alive. And then the next minute, and then a hero comes along and saves him. How's that, eh? That's a good story. That's true. Yeah, so there was quite a push about 15 years back or something. A lot of young people felt they were getting too, hang on, let me just hang a sip of this. Too much strain and stress of the pressures of school, and having to succeed in a lot of pressures, you know. Shit in China, some people top themselves. Some people kill others so they make the other kid look good. Cool. I hear tell that that's true. Anyways. That's a nice rig. Actually, a bloke came to my warehouse with these women all dolled up to the nines, and he bought something off me worth about $5. And then about a week later he contacted me and said, "Oh, I want some more stuff." And then a week later he came back and wanted some more stuff and bought a shit ton of tools and stuff off me. He said, "Oh, I want to get into DIY and I'm teaching him how to use a saw in safety mode." And anyway, so in construction there was a lack of like young people coming into it or something like that. So there was sort of a push via media or whatever to try to get people into the fold of construction. And so you saw, I saw it quite immediately. Let's see if I can do something with this sock. Yeah. With immediacy that you saw an explosion, I presume it's all across the country, of young people getting involved in outdoor physical labour. Physical workers. That's what Exy called this place where a whole bunch of people were, like they had this apartment block, and I said, "Oh, what's going on there?" She said, "Oh, that's for physical workers." Anyways, well, so yeah, there was quite a push for that. So a lot of chicks got involved in the construction industry, and so that's really good, because then a lot of young guys are like, "Shit, and she's a babe." And I've seen some babes driving around in big, heavy, rigid rigs and like big trucks, yeah? You know, like good looking babes too. I'm like, oh, she's alright. And yeah, so that's definitely a way to bring, you know, young strapping lads like myself. Hey, don't laugh. Into the industry, you know, just get some babes in there. Yeah, shit, I remember years ago I was working in some shit old factory. Fuck, I hated it. Anyway, Miss Bird was doing work experience and she must have been all of 17 or something. And so she came along and had a right good chat with her. She was a fun person and she was, you know, I wanted to go to work so I could talk with her. Yeah. How's that? What a babble. Anyways, mate of mine, he's interested in me coming over to check out a whole bunch of these ceramics and stuff. He said, I've got a whole heap of ceramics, I want you to come by. I said, yeah, all right, I'll come and have a look. And then I realised, I just remembered, just recently, the Australian Post, they cancelled sea freight. And it went on for months or something like that. I totally forgot because I was off my banana on the whiskey. Having a bit of a whiskey throttle during that time frame. And it reminds me of, I lost my bicycle. So I'm always on the hunt for my bicycle. Oh. Anyways, I found that this week, I think, Clown World people have decided to unclown world the sea freight for Australia. So that's a positive. Because I said to him on, I think it was Monday, maybe Sunday or something, because he's going to go to this auction house and unload it all on the Tuesday. And because I mentioned to him, I said, shit, I've only just realised that the shipping is out. And then I checked on Wednesday, I think it was, because I just recently contacted him, and I said, oh, they've decided to resume sea freight, you know, and because I've got this sort of bit of an operation going on, and a 4-week operation, every step could mean your last one on too, and it was a war behind yourself. Anyways, so yeah, he goes, oh, yeah, I've still got plenty, come over and pick through it, and see what you want. He said, bring a bunch of cash, and I said, I don't have a bunch of cash. Like, he's freaking, he deals in all kinds of, his wifey poos is probably watching this. She gets a bit of a laugh out of my stuff, apparently. You know, he deals in all kinds of junk, and he said, I am the king of the 100 yen sales or something like that. God, I always get it. Oh shit, what's going on? Where are we going? What's going on right now? Like, all right. I had to run over there one time and help someone. Well, not that one, a different place. Anyways, he goes, I am the king of 100 yen sales or whatever. You just deal in junk. And he points to another guy and he says, he's a scrapper. And I go, yeah, at least he's got some dignity, self-respect, I think. At least he's got some self-respect. And this other bloke, the Japanese guy that speaks English, he just bursts out laughing. Yeah, we have right good banter. Anyways, he goes, I mentioned to him on the liney thing, they've resumed the, no one cares about this story, sea freight option for Australia. So, he said, all right, no worries, come over and pick through it. And he said, maybe we can crack a few and what was his exact words there? And, I'll pitch a tent out in the backyard, you can crash there. I took my tent to Australia, but I might actually have another one. It didn't occur to me to go there and go all the way over there and, drink beers, but, you know. Let's have a look here. What's he got here? I sent a picture of that beer. Is it, hang on. Cool, maybe the backyard blossoms will be blooming. Alright, so he's got cherry blossom trees in the backyard. Sakura, they're called. We can knock a few down. I'll pitch a tent for it. It's cool. Yeah. And this other bloke on there, he's a busker, and he's telling me he's gonna go off to Taiwan. He's already got his visa. He's off to Taiwan for a year's working holiday visa, and his English has definitely improved a lot. I haven't seen him in a while, and he wants to get together. And he said if they don't force him to do overtime on Sunday, we'll get together on Sunday. So that'd be cool.
Peace.
Hopefully, I've been watching some blokes in Taiwan that are living there, and I've been watching a YouTube thing for years. I remember I sent, when I was doing okay with money, I sent the bloke Prozzy there. He was sort of doing hard times when he first got to Taiwan, and so I liked his crew, you know, so I sent him $50 and just as a gesture, help him out. And yeah, he's doing well now, from the looks of it. And I said, this bloke, you might be able to hook up with their crew, a whole bunch of people that speak English and all that. And yeah, I'll at least mention to him who they are. And they're good blokes. Him and that bloke that says he's from England with a strange South African kind of accent. He calls it Taiwan. Anyways, the reason why I'm here right now is because a lady from the States purchased some biwa strings off me, and I figured, oh shit, I'm gonna have to contact. I had a few drinky poos in me last night, I think, when I noticed it, and I thought, oh shit, I'm gonna have to contact that elderly lady and put money in a post box and go through all that again. And then I realised, oh, hang on, some bloke purchased some biwa strings off me and then cancelled. Like, I went and went through all the throes of getting them and cancelled on me. So then I had them right in front of me, in front of my keyboard under some papers. I'm like, hang on, I've got a set, haven't I? And so it's quite ridiculous. You can't just put them in a letter and send it because of Clown World. So I have to send it by EMS. So I'm going to have to get some kind of packaging. I'm going to ask them about it right now. But yeah, I had it with me right in front of me, right there. So I figured I could afford a few beers. That's a win. All right, now, this is my dinky post office. We're really good here.
Yes.
I like the people here. The lady that speaks English, she's retired now, unfortunately. She was really nice. I kind of cracked the shits one day and I walked out in, she come running after me. Anyways, nah, they're real good. Alright, let's go sort this out. Cut. Cause Clown World, you know, I couldn't just put that in a in an envelope like a normal letter and send it. Because Clown World and those filth that created it, never going to forgive them for trying to fucking murder me vicariously. Anyways, that costs like over $30 US just to send that. Yeah? Because I had to send it via EMS. And the size of the item, just strings for a biwa, right, like a shamisen kind of thing, a lute. This bloke's awesome. Yeah. Sometimes he invites me over to check out his garden and all that sort of stuff. Real nice bloke. He introduced me to his wife and all. I think he's got a home in like Kumamoto or something like that too. Anyways, yeah, nice dude. Showed me pictures of his family and all that. Yeah, good bloke. So the size of the package, the parcel-y thing, this big envelopey thing and the tiny, just tiny strings like that. I had a good laugh over that, but that really cut into my beer money, so that was kind of shit. But yeah, because of the creation of Clown World and the filth, I know who they are, you know, have to go through stuff like that. So filth are making wonderful money, or others are getting killed. Yeah, they'll get theirs, they will learn regret in the furtherance. Oh yes. I'd like to be there to see it. Ah, now what we're going to do, got my pack on, we are heading toward the warehouse, and what I'm going to do is jump on the train this time, and then it'll be like an hour and a quarter walk from the train station, and then say an hour and a quarter back, something like that. So that should be pretty cool, and it's just a lovely walk, because right now we're talking about 12 degrees, not so good in the shade. Shit, I wouldn't mind going to the beach right now, I'm just having a beer. Yeah, fuck it, let's do that. Thankfully I had the perceptive mind to go and walk back and shove my t-shirts and beanie back into the pack. Right, so what I'm gonna go and do is one of my good buyers, he said to me, have you still got that ceramic dragon thing in the back of the behind this bronze thingy in the picture? I said, yeah, I plan on sending it to Australia. It's a fantastic piece. I said, oh yeah, if you offer me a decent amount, but I don't know how much it's going to cost. I think I've got it packed and ready to go to Australia ages ago, and so I'm going to have to figure out. I said, oh, I'll air freight the thing. I'm just going to have to figure out the costing. So what I plan to do is just do a little video of it to show him, and my PayPal account, so yeah, I'll show him. It's happyoblivion@hotmail.com, and so hey, ping me off some frickin' beer money, will ya? Shit, I'm serious, I've only got 10 bucks left for beer money, so I'm gonna have to get some more dough. That's just frickin' bullshit. Look at that, I had like 50 bucks on me, and god damn it, stupid. Anyways, oh, welcome to some of my new, got a few new subbies overnight. Now I'm up to 461 loyal Ronin, so that's not bad. Hey, I figured, you know, one day I might crack 500 or something like that, it'd be enough. Yeah. So how many men for us? Oh, about 500, Last Samurai. I'm sporting the last hairstyle, the Last Samurai hairstyle. I'm serious, I'm growing it out at the back. After watching that Kung Fu movie, I'm like, that's it, I'm getting that. And so yeah, I'm gonna, oh no one gives a shit about this story, I'll go and grab a beer, probably get a bit more money, and then we'll go to the beach, which is just over there. Cut. Now that's a tallie. Yeah, like a cookie. That bird in there, she it's a groovy looking rig, that one, eh? Woo. I remember saying to the bloke when he hopped in, nice car, man. Oh, he's banged it up. He's banged up the front of it. He goes, oh, thank you. That bird in there, she's really fun. I like her. She's like, I'm like, yeah, I'm off to the beach now. Oh, nice day for it, you know. Yeah. Some other young girl working there, she came out to say hello when I was, should I go to the Chute de Chine or go to the, oh, go here. And I was having a right good laugh with a bloke out the front there who was drinking beers, and well, I was drinking beers and he was riding a motorcycle, and she came out and had a right good laugh with us. Some of them in my local area, they speak English now. It's a pity this young guy, he's actually brought up in England, my England was, and Hey, Aussie. Ancestry. And he. Oh, that looked rad. I'd love to be into stone, weird, you know. Like, far more than I am. It's just way out of my financial league. Anyways, yeah, that young bloke, you know, he's obviously spoke English, and I think he was like half Japanese or something, and from Japanese stock. That's his, it's Taisho, isn't it? Taisho period's, Senkyaku Juni Kara. Senkyaku Nijiroku Made, from 1912 to 1926 is the Taisho era. Yeah, a bird that speaks English at the my local 7-Eleven Ikebu. Told me, I asked about him, inquired, and she said, oh, he's gone back now, back to England. So that's a pity, because he helped me out with some kind of issue I had with this, what was it, some kind of paperwork or something like that, and he helped me out with that on the computery thing, and he sort of translated that, and we did that, and good bloke. So I think I saw him last week. I had a chat, just a short chat, and off I went. Yeah, like I was saying, if you were to do like the rough guide in Japan, you find places like this, right? Now, I've mentioned this before, and this is, you just go to a local hardware store, right? And you get yourself a little spanner, you see? A little square, spannery type of, sockety type of thing. And that way you can get yourself some free water. Shit. What am I giving out? Medical information, medical advice? The algorithm will get on me. Or, and that way, what you do is, if you don't have a total riot, see, because there's people living all around, you can park yourself into a place like that, you see. And I would say, I suggested, whiskey on the rocks. Thanks. That's what I said. I walked in with a beer at the post office. I said, oh, whiskey on the rocks. you get yourself some mosquito netting. You get that from the local hardware store here anyway. So there's a Suzu Bell up there. And then you can come to places like this, you see. They're all over Japan. Right? So, you know, plonk yourself in a hotel once a week or something, you know, for the showery poos. Just jump in the water over there, that big watery thing over there, and you have yourself an excellent way to get around and a place to stay, you see. Well, basically it's just to keep out of when all that wet stuff comes from up there. It's a Suzu Bell. I think that says something about Hono. I don't know if that's Hono, maybe that's different. Kakui. Hello. Suzu Bell. This kid's like, what's going on with this guy? Okashi mitai hito. He's a gaijin-san, crazy gaijin. There we go, and there's all the names of the people that are involved in the shrine, you see. Let's see if we can shake this Suzu bell. Wow! There you go. So yeah, a place like this, perfect opportunity for like rough guide travelers. Yeah, you got your big watery thing over there we can go and have a look at. This kid's just staring at me. Oh, Kashi Gaijin! With the Last of Samurai hairstyle, look at that! Mata mata, yo! Yeah. I think that thing's there, that box is Heisei Hachinen Shigatsu, I think that's the auspicious day. So Heisei starts in the Senkyuhaku Hachijuku Nen, which is 1989. Hachigatsu, the August. Hachi Nen. Right, so that'd be the 8th year of the Heisei period. So you go 89, 97, go back 1 year for the full year of 89. So I think that's 1996, and Shigatsu, which would be January, February, March, April, and I think that's auspicious day generally means like the 20th of the month, something like that. So there you go, and that's that. Now this place here, the reason why they've made it all out of just concrete, right, is because they had to rebuild this many a time because of the salt air from that big watery thing over there. So we'll go and have a look at the big watery thing. Now see, a lot of people come here middle of the night. These are all sake one cups. This happens all the time. Look at that, you've even got a thing on the inside. Oh, advertisement on the inside. Hey, there's a business opportunity for someone. And one cup sake. Sake, as we like to call it, sake. So these are all one cup sakes. Now they would have been positioned over there where people come and shake and do a shaky and a clap. And with that Suzu belt. And pray to their ancestors on the fallen and stuff like that. See, that's a Tolly Heaven's Gate, and there's another big Tolly over there. Sometimes a huge Tollies. Okay, and here you'd have in bloom. I think that'd be like in autumn or something. This here hasn't bloomed yet. This is a sakura. Sakura key, right, and it hasn't bloomed yet for some reason. Maybe it's too old now or something like that. Okay, let us tall beers. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Right on. There you go. Oh, isn't that cool? Shishi. Shishi lion dog. Concepts of Shinto. Yeah, so it's one of the fanciest of shrines I've ever been to. But locale, I mean, this is Imajuku. The area name is Imajuku in the west Nishiku, which is the west ward of Fukuoka. And it's not a bad location if you were to. I don't know, I can't remember my name most of the time. So yeah, you know, if you're rough guiding it, with the skill I have in the Gagi Gugu Baba Boo Boo, could be possibly maybe baby language, I could hitch around. In fact, I don't even know if it's illegal to. I think it's illegal in Australia, isn't it? I don't give a shit, I did it for 6.5 years. To hitchhike. Let's find out, shall we? I'll be back in a second.
Yeah, it's coming.
Okay, so I searched the god of Google. Google knows everything. Yeah. They're bad people and they're good people. Because we said so. Yeah. Anyways, so it says that it's not illegal to hitchhike in Japan. And it says something like that police have sort of wide ranging powers, it says, to if you're distracting traffic or some kind of nuisance to traffic or whatever. But yeah, so in general, and so with the level that I have in the Gagi Gugu, Baba Gugu, could be possibly maybe baby language, I could hitch around Japan, no problem. I've done it, you know, I've hitched a fair bit in this land, but you know, I'm thinking, shit, wouldn't it be cool if I just hitchhiked, just drink beers, put out a bit of a sign, and go to like Kagoshima again? God, it's good there. I wanna go to Shikoku. I'm gonna do that one day. There's a pink cherry blossoms are out, see they? Pink and whitey ones. And go to Kagoshima, get on the ferry, take this pack, my backpack we all got, and get on the ferry, and the short trip over to Sakurajima, which is this volcano in the middle of the bay of the city of Kagoshima, and it is freaking fruit tingles, I'm telling you. You can hire a bicycle, and you can't sort of get right around it, but sort of ish. It actually created itself its own peninsula, but at one stage it was, which is fairly recent, at one stage it was just an island with a volcano on it. And it, oh man, it is, wow. Yeah. Oh, I'm serious, it's fucking fruit tingly beautiful. Yes. I might ask that bloke while I'm here, if he could fix my tablet. He sorted me out for a mobile phone, and I gave him a whole bunch. I had like 8 of them of my iPhone 3. I had iPhone 3 for years, and every now and again it would die, and then I'd just get another one off the net and then take out the memory cardy thing and change. I end up with about 8 of them, and they're a bit of a collector's item apparently, so I just gave them to him. He's like, shit man, thanks, you know, so there you go. Every now and then I'll go in there and give him a beer. Good bloke. Let's see if he's open. I think he's closed on Wednesday. Let's have a look. Hang on. Over here, see? Phone repairs. iPhone fast fix store. Right. Yeah, he's a good bloke, that one. There was an elderly lady in there, and I said, oh, sorry, I'm just walking by, having a beer, and asking a question. She's like, oh, she was really cool. Anyways, yeah, I was asking about my Lenovo tablet, whether he could fix and like put a new microphone or something in it, and he said, oh no, and it's best that I just pick up another one, because electronics are pretty cheap, and so I'll still use it for books and things like that, for online, what do you call it, e-books and things, which I've got it in my backpack right now. And so I'll just use it for that. I'll have to get hold of another one, so that's cool. And I motioned to him about the other beer I had, and because sometimes I give him beers, and he goes, oh, yeah, I'll have that. And I go, oh, no, that's mine. He goes, oh, and I go, oh, all right, then. And then the lady's just laughing. And then that communication that we have, because we communicate in English and Japanese, you know, it's kind of funny. I think the dude's into surfing. He had a surfboard from Australia. That's how we first got to sort of talking on a friendly level, you know. Yeah, and he's the one that suggested that I get this one to help out with the QR codey things and all that shit. And fantastic, a freaking lifesaver, really, that bloke. There's a whole bunch of iPhone 3 and iPhone 3Gs in there on his display, and half of them I gave to. I gave them to. And I said, "Oh, book, I'll give you sure." And that's when with that lady. She says, "Oh, honey, what's that?" And she's looking at her like it's so, like they're freaking antiques. Like, she's looking at an antique freaking, you know, 1920s telephone or something. Alright, so we're going to have to replenish the ranks here. Okay, Chronicles are ready. Just I flicked that off, I had a look at this and then there's a tickle. Check this out. Yeah, Tyco, man. Whoa. Now, if you ever like in the vicinity of a Tyco group, like just going nutso, they used to do that before Clown World, they'd have the fireworks like after just heading into autumn or whatever. And at Imajuku Beach, and it's fantastic. They have a big Taiko group and a stage. Whoa, other fantastic times there. Been there quite a number of years, actually.
Yes.
Right, let's continue on. Okie dokie. You know, if I had bought the, wasn't so stupid, and bought the lead along, I could have charged this battery whilst I was on the that big long dangerous animal thing that runs over Indians and shit. Anyways, they stopped spray painting the brake assemblies in the color of gold because they were ripping off the braking assemblies thinking that it was made out of gold. Yeah, from one of those big animals that come along and just clean out loads of them. Now, what we're going to do is get some of this stuff.
Yes.
Yeah, this is Japan's rendition of the George Floyd tribute sculpture. I mean, it's just as shit, but a whole lot cheaper. How's that grift, eh? Yeah, what did they get out of that? Freaking millions, that's what they got out of it. Someone on fentanyl put that together. Look at that. God damn, what a piece of shit.
You can't say that.
Yeah, but he was on fentanyl, and I saw the whole 18 minutes of the body cams, and
but I didn't see that on CNN, so it's not true.
No, I'm serious. I saw it before, even in the district attorney. The black guy said, oh, shut up, you bastard. You know, didn't want to release the footage so that he could be certain of a conviction. That's withholding evidence. You dumb cunt.
Yeah,
and the apes that watch CNN, they're like, oh, yeah. That's the truth. Yeah, but I know a different truth. Like the real truth. Yeah. Be certain of a conviction to withhold evidence. I'm a district attorney. And the McFlys go, and the McFlys go, defund those police. Imagine who wants to be a cop now. Hey, let's set up Chaz and call the police when some people get shot, but while we're saying that we will defend the police and we don't want the police, no cops, we'll call the shop no cops. And when a couple people got shot in the Chaz community, who they call? The cops. And the McFlys go, McFly, hello. I'd love to ride a mountain bike down this. Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
Ah, it's so lovely. District. Now I'm going all the way over there. And the McFlys go, duh. Oh, we had that big moony poos over there, and there's the sun. Yeah. And the McFlys go duh. I was just reading a bit of, the reason why I'm saying this is I just read a bit of Yahoo News, so I can read into what they're actually trying to say with the agenda, and figure out who I'm supposed to hate. And the McFlys go duh. Memories like the corners of my demigod existence. Now, I recall it costs about 2 tallies to get to the warehouse. About this, from this walking poos here. Yes, I think it does. Something like that. Now, I do know there's a service station over there that's got a dunny, so that's good. No one cares about this story. McFly, duh. Yeah. Okay, now, what we're going to do is just keep going that way and try to get to the warehouse, pick up this thing and come back. Mate saying, hey, how about we get together and drink some booze? And I'd send him a picture of, I'm out here drinking booze. Gotta do some internet-y bullshit tonight. Yeah, okay, no worries. And, but that's cool. You know, see, when the weather comes on, it's great, you know. Like, in Japan, in springtime, like, when the weather's on, man, and, oh, shit. There's a lady that had a real dog. That bloke's got one of those dumb, untrainable dogs, mutts, and the Muttleys, and she's got this, like, I don't know, what do you call those, fucking bull mastiff or some bloody thing, and I said, and it's looking at me, and it's like, I'm right on the tether of the leash, and she's holding him back, and he's looking at me. I think he just wanted to play, he was fairly young, and a big sort of, big mutt for Japan, for certain. And I go, oh, kawaii, I mean scared. Kawaii, yo, oi, I'm scared. And I said to the mutt, oi, boku wa oishu kanai desho. And, hey, I'm not tasty. See, look at that. They got the old, what do you call those, convertible rig going on there. Yeah, I'm telling you, springtime in Japan, man. It's freaking fantastic. This bloke's out having a bit of a joggy poos. See, he's not one of those dickheads that wears a face diaper while he jogs. When are they going to get rid of the face diaper? Some foreign savage was saying to me, they might just keep it going forever. Fucking slaves. Anyways, rain slaves. That's alright. You know, to be free, man. To be free. Yeah. I've fought for that all my life and I've tasted it. Yeah, quite a number of occasions. Granted, you've got to be in this social expectation kind of thing. I was sort of, you know, I'm on the sort of the parameters and perimeters and extenuators. God, I've been watching the Salty Cracker too many times on Rumble. Salty Cracker. Where are we now? My Brew Interchange. Senyoji Dai. Temple and Mount Rai. Mabru Interchange South Industrial Park and the Itoshima Research Park. Right, now, and the reason why I'm doing this is I'm waiting to drop this one. Nearly there. You can do it. Okay. Now, what's happening again? Oh, look at that. Lucky fucking day, man. Yeah. Yeah. Just found 10 yen. Okay. Might get some good luck from that. Yeah, this doesn't happen every day. Check this out. There's that big Mooney Poos. See, that's all white. And there we go. Oh, okay. We might have stopped. Ah, there we go. Good. I was sort of thinking about whether I might have a squishy in my Dax. No. If I needed to take a bit more of a shit or something. Oh god, did you really say that? Yeah. And I'm like, so I figured I'd just check, have a bit of a checky poo. So I hop on the throne, and all of a sudden this, I'm thinking, ah, shit. Because I was thinking about, like, freedom and attaining freedom, and I've tasted it, you know, just briefly over a few times in my life, and because I was born a slave, and I was thinking, you know, I could die now, go straight back into the furtherance again, and I'll be all right with that, you know, wouldn't mind going back there, and then it's kind of like maybe the gods decided, okay, let's see if he really feels that way, and suddenly some fucking blood just started gushing out of my right nostril on my leg as I had my Dax down. So I'm wiping freaking blood off myself. Oh, that looks nice, doesn't it? That rice field over there. Yeah, we might have to go on a bit of an investigation. Investigation time. Well, let's just fucking cross the door. Let's just do it. I'm going in the further ones. I don't give a fuck. Anyways. And yes, some blood just started pouring out of me. I'm thinking, oh shit, maybe I haven't recovered from my injuries after all. Like my, I don't know what this place is. Yeah, maybe I haven't recovered from my injuries after all. Like the brain injuries and shit. A few of them. I was attacked anyways as a child, so who gives a fuck. Survived that, didn't I? Sort of. Anyways, yeah, so just blood's just coming out of my nose. Like, not from the nose, but from inside. Yeah, what was that about? And then it stopped. But look at that, isn't that beautiful? Huh? Is that like a fucking... This is gate ball. A gate ball basho. Yeah, what was that about? Hey. Right. Call it a gate ball, this guy. Gate ball. Yeah, top of them. Gate ball, ne. Kakui, ii basho, this and that. So, yo. Ii basho means a good place. So, yeah, this is gate ball. He didn't know. So, clearly, he's not a gate ball fan. Let's have a look. They've got gate ball equipment in there. It's like a, what do they call that, croquet or whatever? Sort of like a golf thing. It's got Farmer Joe and Farmer Mary over there. This is what I came to see when I glanced at from across the road there. So yeah, what was that? Just a blood purge or something? Years ago they used to utilize leeches. We've come a long way. Duh. And the apes go, duh. I don't know, maybe the gods were, there's Farmer Joe's rig over there. Maybe the gods were saying, hey, I can hear a whole bunch of kids at that school over there. Yeah, the gods probably saying, hey, alright, how about we just take you out? And so I've been waiting. And waiting, God, for them to fucking come and pick me up. I crash landed on the planet of the fucking apes. You know, I've been waiting to get off this fucking rock. See, we're too far away. It's the problem, they sent me out to, you know, find other civilizations and shit, and what did I find? Clown world, where everyone's gay and trans. Yeah. Yeah. There you go. Anyway, so I've been waiting for them to come and send a ship. I sent signals. They're probably like, let's just have a bit of a laugh. They're probably just watching me and going, yeah, man, it's, yeah, like it's a freaking Truman, it's an alien style Truman show. They're all having a freaking laugh, aren't they? Yeah, aren't ya? You're all out there just going, oh. Yeah, thanks for calling me Darren, by the way. Yeah, that's, you know, what, do you hate me? What have I ever done to deserve this anyway? Shinto Shrine. Yeah, have to investigate. Yeah. Mm. What do we got here? This is a Tully Heaven's Gate. Fucking these big flags. Ooh, here, see, they hang the. The big Nobori flags. I listed a few. In fact, I did a video on it, and I accidentally deleted the video. Yeah. So that's a pity. I mean, they look like they're having a good time, eh? This old Farmer Joe and Farmer Mary over there. Looks like they're from different. Oh, there's a Farmer Mary, Farmer Joe, and Farmer. Katie or whatever. It's a she-lion dog. Hey man, how's it going? You shit, you bastard. Jesus. Take it easy. This one's a whole lot more friendly. Anyway, mate. Some Suzu bells. Sometimes these are just open. So if you're on a shoestring, you could just sort of rock into some of these places. Oh, that's got a lock on it. But yeah, at least you could crash under the eave or just hop under there to keep out of the rain. And there's often booze, so you could just grab a few. Often, shrines have got, Farmer Joe's looking at me like, who's that fucking whoa, look at that. What a shot. Yep. Photo time, moon and flagpoles. Yep. This happens sometimes when you don't have a whole lot of sidewalk, as they call them in the States. Rack of sakura trees over there. There's some leeks, man. They've got some leeks going on. Oh, yeah. Yeah, if it wasn't for Clown World and those filthy bad people with the bereft of honor and courage, yeah, my money wouldn't have been stolen and I would have been well on the way. I was well on the way to getting my own little plot. I just go and fuck it. I won't even bother waiting for the to get picked up, and those assholes, and I say, hey, how come you're like a trillion years late? And they're like, oh, we'll just have a bit of a laugh, you know. I'm like, yeah, okay, what about a bit of a laugh? How about you turn around and fuck off? The ubiquitous patron. See, he's a local farmer, this bloke. I was gonna go through there and have a bit of a walkie poos. I think I might go through there on my own sometime without you. Look how many birdies are in there. Hey, they like that tree for some reason. Yeah, that's Edo, man. See that? See the? I can tell by the under the I'd like to walk over there, but all these freaking cars under the Kalara, which is the roof tiles. You can see the mud pack, and that is up. So it's just whatever. See how some of them are broken away, and you can see. I know from, because I just know everything, but that's Edo period, 1603 to 1868, that building, and probably modified and repaired and shit over the years. That's why those birds are so rat to be there, because they know they're safe, hey? There's a beautiful joint up there. Now, never been up there. That's a manor house, or I think it's a manor house. local farm district owner or something like that. Like, would have been the landlord or something like that back in the day. Some dude forgot that you're supposed to stick those things on the water. Cabbagey. Yeah, I could survive. You know, the clown world, spark it off. Because clowns, they're all like in their late 80s and they want to make a name for themselves and have the nukes fire off. Yeah, I can just walk around and eat that. Jump and drag that thing into the sea over there and eat some fishy poos. It's a fucking survivalist, you know? Look at that. Look at that manor house up there, man. Look at that. The clown world. Filth. Have tremendous wealth. But they have this concept that he who has the most, when he's like dies and shit, wins. And that's not exactly the case. It means you're a fuckwit. See, if you have benevolence, beauty within your soul, see, the filth don't have that. They don't know what it is. They don't know the laughter of children, for instance. Look at these kids over here, and a right good laugh, a good time. Yep, they don't know love. They can't know love, because no one will love some ugly bastard from ugly from the outside and ugly on the inside. It just can't happen, you know? So they're jealous and they're pissed off and they hate people like me, see? Love. I believe that love is a trillion to one, and I've met it twice. Yeah. Shit, and I on three times a different type. Beautiful there, eh? Hello! Konnichiwa! Yeah, hey. Isn't this beautiful? I like this place. Yeah. There was a joint over there that I was trying to buy. Shit, yeah, I was trying to buy it. I had half the money. You know? And it had its own little private beach. Not private, it was its own little public. It basically had its own little beach. Yeah, would have been fine. I would have been fine. I would have just told them, hey, you can turn your spaceship around and piss off. I'm happy enough here. Yeah, but I can hear that helicopter coming back. I wondered if it was military or not. It's over there somewhere. Because it was heading on the flight path. So the flight path of one of them goes over, a few of them go over there to Saga and all that. That one is on the flight path down to Sasebo, so I presume they're heading back? Probably, yeah, I think it might be military. They're talking about phasing them out, how's that? Because those man pads these days, you know, take them out a whole lot easier than they could back in the day, and man pad. Ah, Dylan will get on TikTok. Ah, you can't say man pad. I'm gonna have my poopy period now. Old Innsman. Oh god, I couldn't get through that video listening to that fuckwit. Some dickhead's talking about men having poo periods or some shit now. You know, what's next? I'm like, so you reckon you could get yourself a freaking hobby that's slightly different with your man-made vagina? You know, you can't help these apes. You can't help them. I tried. Maybe I was here. I thought that, right? I was supposed to come here to help and sort of, you know, the extenuations of the universes of the, like the pods that we sent out centuries ago. But, no, you can't help these apes. They're doomed. They're fucking doomed. Man poopy periods now. What's next? What are you gonna up yourself with that? How about this? Let's tell people that white people are bad and adopt little white kids and then abuse them and kill them. Yeah. Oh no, you just made that up. This is CNN, the most trusted news. No, did I just make that up or did it really fucking happen? Eh? This is CNN. WNDs, fucking Orange man bad. White straight man bad. Russia. Russia. Ah, that's better. sun going down. It's taking a whole lot longer than I expected. Darkness imprisoned me. All I see. Something or other. I cannot live. All that kind of horror or some shit. I cannot live. I cannot die. Something or other. And that too, yeah. It's still going. God damn it. Stupid walking. There was a stalky just down here. I can still see him. He's way over there now. He's in a bit of a fly. He poos. Big one. Big male. Off he goes. He wasn't too pleased with it. I just happened to show up. He's like, what the fuck are you doing here? Off he goes. I can still see him. Look at that. All the way over there. Try to find freedom. Yeah, he's seeking freedom, man. If you could just taste it, yeah, you've won. You know, you can just taste it. Freedom. I'm talking about soul shit. You know, if you can be free, you can find that freedom. You know, hopefully you're of good soul, and then once you're free. Then, once you've tasted it, then you've got a chance to like when you're in the furtherance, they, like, alright, you get upgraded. Yeah. It's like that. It's like, you ever felt when you sort of come of age, or you get older, or you reach a transitional stage?
Transitional stage? I mean, intersectionality.
Yeah, reach a transitional stage in your age. Yeah, it's a real thing. Yeah, a certain sort of feelings, emotions. It's like I'll prove it to you. It's like when you're a kid and you have this thing, it's kind of like it's right behind you. It keeps telling you. It's a good conscience thing. It's trying to tell you, hey, follow this path and don't do this and don't do that. They're like, bad shit. Shit, we're going to go over this. Yeah, fuck it. I cannot live. I cannot die. It's kind of like these otherworldly sort of stuff, feelings, and that happens. I don't know if everyone gets that, but I get that. Sort of like stages of life, and you've reached it's like a new level or something like that. Yeah. Captain fucking spirituality, man. Well, I'm gonna start listening to freaking Santos Bonacci with all these freaking what does he call that bullshit again? Transcendental fucking no. What's he call that shit? Hang on, I'll be back. I'll find it. Syncretism. They jump from one fucking crystal. Carbon, like, fucking power to whatever. Ah, that's not working. Let's go with Guy. Let's go with that. Let's go with this. Let's go with that. Look, I am the way. I am the path, and I fucking know it. Everyone knows that.
Hey, this place look alright. We'll tell the government it's a sacred site. Dead fucking easy.
Right then. Now, there's a bit of a laughing. The bloke in the truck that drove by, he's just laughing. He's just fucking crazy going, cruising along, just drinking beers. Free as shit. Free as the birds, man. Yeah. And just, he's just laughing. I probably made his day, man.
Oh, look. That white stuff on top of the mountains is not there anymore.
They got loads of it in Canada. Actually, I was watching Sergey, walking around. Shit, what was the place called? Olomsk, or whatever. I don't know. Central Southern Russia. And he's walking around this city, and just showing the region. I watch him quite a bit. And I don't think he sort of responds to my messages when I'm in the live, because I'm always subscribing just shit. Like, I'm always drunk when I'm watching his stuff, and I'm always scribing, hey, where are the blondies, or dibs on that blondie as he's walking past me. And I'm like, hey, where are all the drug addicts? You know, it's always the same shit. But the truth is, what he portrays is real. It's some serious fucking reality right there. Yeah, I've been watching this guy for decades, man. Nearly, yeah. And he goes around Russia and just shows what real Russia is. He used to have Real Russia Vlog, and that was what it's called. And these days, he calls it by his own name, it's Sergey Blagologologologlof, or whatever. I can't pronounce Russian stuff. To me, Russians are all, I don't know, what's that fucking word for it, where you can't read and shit, because all this C's and E's and B's, and they're all back to front, aren't they? Yeah? I even forgot the freaking word for it. Anyways, what do they stick in this stuff? I thought these are supposed to be energy drinks. Can't read the fucking card, you cannot. All this fucking nonsense, I don't know. Anyway. I mean, what does DNA stand for anyway? National Dyslexic Association. I mean, come on. Mountain Hawk City. He's been up there soaring away on the thermals for quite a while. Kawasu Crow. Here's some more of these going over and hanging out with his mates. A few over there. You've been watching me for quite a spell on the trail there, haven't you? What was the line? You've been watching me for quite a while on the trail. You've been watching me on the trail for quite a while. No, Joey. Guess I was. 1953 movie Shane. Yes, isn't it? Don't it piss you off when you, like, people pick out some bloopers, you know, and they sort of made a few errors and stuff. Back in the day, you couldn't just sort of go, all right, we'll just, you know, redo that bit or whatever. You know, they had to overdub, because in the initial stages of the movie, the Alan Ladd forgot what the kid's name's supposed to be. Joey. Yeah, doesn't that suck? It kind of taints the film, you know? Well, not for me. I can just... I have the ability to just... You're finished. Like that. So it doesn't matter. And, what a beautiful film, eh? Shane. 1953. If you haven't seen that movie, then you're not even deserving of getting into the furtherance, alright? You'll just have to stay here for fucking ever. Yeah. Yeah. What a beautiful film, huh? Yes. Actually, my father introduced me to that film. Yes. Beautiful bloody movie, wasn't it? Alan Ladd. You know, they used to call him Shorty, and apparently, psychologically, it harmed him, you know? So there was a period of time there in the States, whatever you're supposed to be. I guess for military service or something, they were tall, strapping, big German-looking dudes or something like that, and that kind of stock. But, you know, I'm not the tallest bloke in the universe, but I'm just better than all of you, obviously, because I just am. I mean, reality, you know. Don't blame me. Don't blame the messenger. That's your fucking problem. But anyway, it's not your fault. I'm just better than you. That's the truth. Everyone knows that. Anyways, it's a classy. Smartest bird in the universe. I was supposed to save one years ago. Well, maybe not supposed to. Maybe I should have let it go. Same with, like, on Fukuoka Now website. there's a girl there, she's saying, she's in Karume, she's saying there's a cat, a little kitten, you know, someone can save the kitten and all that. Fuck, you know, but I can't. I do, say, if I had a fucking permanent visa in this country, I would go straight there, get that cat, and offer it to the bloke, right, that lost the RIP cat, and offer it to him if he said, no, I don't want another cat, don't want the pain, you know. I'd keep it. If I had a permanent visa, I would do that. Yeah, I would. And look after it. Yeah. Some bastard will probably come along and try to poison it anyways. I don't know if I've got a stalker, a new stalker. Used to have one. That fucker. He's probably still running. Yeah. But, the RIP cat, he alerted me to some noises outside, and so I had a bit of a glancy poos outside, and suddenly a torchlight went out. Now, I don't know who it was. I could probably ask those. You start to piss me off when you do that, you know that? Understand that? Yeah. You did that to me in the middle of the fucking night one time, eh? You're lucky. You're lucky I'm belligerent. Less. Yeah. And this torchlight went off, and I could have leaped over and just gone all parkour over that guttering systems and said, hey, hello, who are you? I could have. I have a few summations, is that even a word? Of the reasonages as to why that creature was there or more. But I'm not even gonna bother to fucking ask. Okay. Don't fucking get. Ah. I'll find out eventually. Probably don't want to know. Be a laugh if I have another stalker, because so regular I don't even bother to lock my door and shit. Wouldn't it be a laugh if I walk in the door someday and there's some fuckface? I asked a cop years ago. I said, what's the law in Japan? If some bastard's in your place stealing your shit, can you kill him? I said, yes, you're legally allowed to. Yeah. Hope you're listening. To whom it may concern. Cut. This is a sad spot just around here. I was going a bit too fast in the K truck around here, and if I wasn't speeding it wouldn't have happened. This beautiful bird came flying out of this region here, it happened over there, and slammed straight into my rig, and I saw it happening. Well, it happened right over there, and birdie, and so I looked in the rear view, and shit, and he went under the rig, and so I stopped here and went out, and classic crow right there. Yeah, happened right here, and that's how I said I was supposed to, I don't know, supposed to, but I should have saved a colossal crow years ago, and I didn't. Fucking hate myself for that, and I hate myself for this too. And I shot a bird once years ago, and it was looking up at me and saying, "Why the fuck did you do this?" And I hate myself for that too. I was like a teenager then, and it happened right here. So he went under, and I picked him up and I put him in the rig and I took him back to the warehouse, and I was thinking, shit, what can I do? And well, back to the battery that ran out of power. You leave him alone for a while and they come back with a little bit. But, still not there. Still haven't even made it. Oh, just keep on soldiering on. This bloke does amazing work, this guy. Right, now. Shit, why don't I just watch that again tonight? Yeah. Okay, now, what we're going to do... Still haven't even made it to the place. I kind of felt a bit of pain back there for Birdie. He's in the furtherance. Don't you worry, he's alright. That was my fault. So, he's well protected. That's for certain. Right, let's keep going. My, my. Look at this. It's like a cloud of birdies. They're all having a blasty poos over here. They're all just settled back down. Both batteries way low on power. That one just ran out again. Got a little bit of power in this. Am I freaking kidding? I sold this for $100. I'm gonna have to ask for the... I have to pay. Oh no, come on now. Oh, this is a real deal, man. I said I would. I have to uphold my honor-bound inclinations. And I had this ready for, to go to Australia, actually. Squeeze dragons right out. Got it. Okay. Alright, I'll pack it and... The air freighter. Actually, I'll have to half pack it, because the air freighter always wants to see what I'm actually... I have to reopen so they can inspect it. Yeah, that's what I have to do. Fuck, it's getting cold. Well, luckily I brought along some t-shirts and shit. Alright, really, early on next week I'm gonna get back into the Gymotti. I've got a spring for that, for the carburetor, so I'm gonna... No one cares about this fucking story. Now, pack that. Go. Take a while. Guess who just called me? It's Chloe. Noon time. Don't have any food for him. Now this thing is just all. Just a meato. Just gonna fit. It's ridiculous. I'm selling this for sort of after fees. What do I get? Nothing. You know, this is a freaking donation, man. I'm serious. This is a freaking donation. Are you kidding me? It's worth fucking billions. But you know, what does it matter? There you go. Chloe followed me down here. He's just over there in the tree. Isn't that nice of him? He flew down and popped on there and then...
What is democracy? What is democracy?
Got something to do with young men killing each other, I believe.
When it comes to my turn, will you want me to go?
For democracy. Any man would give his only begotten son.
He's over there. Can't see him right now. Get him the glare. Alright, I've got this ceramic thing on my back.
It is impossible for a decelerated
individual. I don't want to give it away. I might have to cancel that. I mean, I can't. No, this is just ridiculous. After fees and shit and what I pay for it, I'm gonna have to say that, like, nah, mate, sorry. Yeah, that's. Nah. I'm gonna turn it back. Nah, that's it. I'm turning back. There's no fucking way I can. This is worth. There is no price. There is no price. Sorry. It can't be. No, it's. Nah. I mean, honor is honor and all, and I said, yeah, yeah, no worries, but, nah, that's, come on, man, that's just, nah, that's a part of me, man, right, that's a part of me. I said, I plan to send it to Australia, you see, so someday I might have my own place and keep it, or just, you know, ask my brother to keep it for me, you know, and take care of it. Oh, I'm gonna turn around and go back. I got my rigging all. I'm all keyed out. Hang on. Yeah, I can't do that. That's just wrong. I mean, I've got honor and all. I've got beauty and, but you know, there's certain things that memories and shit like that. You know, I'm not gonna sell my fucking memory. Got a much lighter pack, that's for certain. I went back and took it back. Corey's up there in that tree. He just told me again. He's here. Yeah, the gods stepped in, didn't they? And I said, hey, you know, it's a part of you. It's a depiction of you. It's an artwork of a particle of you. When the dragon enters. Yeah, so that's a piece of me. And they explained to me that I shouldn't do that. Otherworldly stuff, huh? A part of me. A particle. Piece of the puzzle. How's that, huh? I thought it was just a piece of clay. Whoops. It's when the dragon enters. Yeah. Well, it's not easy being me. Oh, I'm just driving. I can't. Shoot it, goddamn ball to save my life, but that's okay. I met these blokes and they're cool as shit. Having fun, learning how to lose. Yeah, well, you gotta do that sometimes.
Elemental forces caused the egg to hatch. From it then came a stone monkey. The nature of monkey was irrepressible.